The class Art 130, Art and Science in the Age of Leonardo and Galileo, met in the Loeb Art Center, and we had Professor Joseph Tanski from the chemistry department showing us, doing a demonstration and introducing us to the technology X-ray fluorescence, XRF.
The technique of X-ray fluorescence is used a lot in the art world to make sure that the pigments in the paintings are consistent with what the artist would have used at the time.
3 weeks ago, our class came to the Loeb Art Center and we looked at this piece with our eye. And one of the questions we came up with concerned this one figure to the right of the cross who's wearing a green robe that has wonderful ornate detailing in either a gold or a yellow. And we couldn't really figure out with the naked eye what the artist was doing. And so in the course today, using this instrumentation, we learned about the specific colors and the elements in the pigments of those colors. We were able to determine that the artist himself was able to simulate gold using yellow and white and other pigments, and not actually gold itself. The idea of bringing in different disciplines and applying them is an important part of the course that I'm teaching this term.
In the real world, there's not like these defined lines. It's not just going to be you do arts or you do science, so I think it's just more preparing us for the real world.
The opportunity to bring the different perspectives of, from an art historian and that of a chemist, to look at the same work of art from two entirely different points of view, and to bring their knowledge, expertise, and enthusiasm for the work that they're doing in the laboratory or in the classroom, and how that can be applied to the Art Center and to our collections, is something that we want to foster and promote to the extent that we can.